Welcome, good morning. Today we have a good video for you on what we do here. I know a lot of you guys have asked a little bit of the process of how we do it. So I'm gonna show you today the first step of our process on how we scan cars around here. This is my buddy Alex's S2000.
Hey, my name's Alex. This is my yellow S2000 AP1 2002. Adam came up to me and asked if I could help him bring my car over, and yeah, I brought it over and he said he needs to scan it.
We have a project with a customer on where we're going to develop a front lip, a little modified version of the OEM lip. So let's get right to it and let me show you what goes into the scanning process. So to quickly explain how this specific scanner works, it's something called structured light. So what it does is it projects a kind of a grid pattern that's invisible to the eye and sees how that grid deforms to be able to tell the general shape of the scanner. So the reason why I'm spraying this down is because of the way the scanner works, if I don't, the light will go through the windshield and scan the interior of the car, which is useful if I want to scan like the vents and stuff, but I only actually care about the exterior for today. So I'm spraying down anything that's semi-clear reflective, and then I also need to spray down the roof because for whatever reason it does not like gloss black surfaces. It can't see its own reflection. I just need to spray down the taillights, any reflectors, and then this stuff will simply just wipe off, so I'm not too worried about it. So you can see with a car, if I have a field distance of here, I'm not going to be able to tell the difference between here and here, because a big hood is, you know, a very simple shape and it's very hard to tell the difference. So what we do is, because our scanner scans in color, we're going to add kind of the equivalent of like reflective markers, but just a little less low tech. And I'm going to scatter large areas that have no features with masking tape. So with the Artec Eva, my view distance is approximately maybe a foot and a half by a foot. So I'm using that in mind to prep my scanning. So you're gonna see this car basically covered in dots. And because my scanner scans in color, it'll be able to use those dots to.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Locate itself. Is this car ceramic coated? This car is ceramic coated, so the tape doesn't fucking stick on it. Oh god, this is gonna suck. Oh no! Nothing sticks, dude.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. So now that I know this car is ceramic coated, I'm actually gonna do something a little more conventional. I'm gonna take a dry erase marker so that I know that it won't stick. And I'm just gonna just draw big X's on the car. And this will give me the color tracking. So I'm gonna draw big X's. And this should help with the scan tracking. So I'm putting X's anywhere that's like a large uncovered surface. My main concern is whether or not the scanner can see this X. So this particular scanner needs to be attached to a laptop. So I have it on a dolly so I can move it around, but I'm gonna go ahead and start. So let's see if you can see the green X's. The answer to that question is no. Yeah, so my markers aren't dark enough, so I won't see it. And then I can't get masking tape to stick to it. So I found a black one. We're gonna see if black works. Black should work. There's just not enough contrast for it to see it, so we're gonna try again. Okay, cool, it worked. Sick.
Oh, because it picks it up from different angles.
Yeah, it picks it up from different angles. Exactly. So do this one. So it's basically using itself, the previous frame of itself, to figure out where it is in 3D space.
Yeah.
And that's why the frame rate's so important.
Is the prep process the same for the better? Too.
My better scanner? Yeah, it's just the field of view is slightly larger.
Yeah.
So the dots will just be less scattered.
Yeah.
Or the tape, whatever. But the scanner does have like the same fundamental problems.
Yeah.
In which it does not scan It does not scan black surfaces really well.
Yeah.
It's better. And then on top of that, frame rate's better, field of view is better, so it's a lot faster.
Yeah.
And then most importantly, the processing is internal. Mm-hmm. So I don't get frame rate drops based on current computer workload.
Yeah.
Right. And also it's obviously very mobile, which is the other nice thing.
Yeah, I think it's supposed to wrap around this. And then...
In that case, let's actually put on a holster. Let's sag.
If we can get to the weekend.
So we started at 10:30. It's now 12:57. So it only took about an hour, 2 hours, and 2.5 hours. So it's not too bad for an Artec Eva. If we used a Leo, it probably would have taken only an hour. So that's kind of where your money goes. All right, let's clean up. Now that we're done with the scanning side of things, I'm going to go back to my computer and we processed the scan and exported it as an STL. I completely forgot to record the processing process. So again, if you want to watch a more in-depth video of like the actual Artec scanning, let us know. But this is kind of what the car looks like. So you can see full 360. We added these wheels and the brake calipers artificially just because we don't need to necessarily scan the wheels. And we can change that however we want. And this is what the car looks like. Since Artec scans in color, we actually are gonna go ahead and import this as well. And these are the textures we got from the car. So you can see here, Steven is a hoe. And we have all the markers that we had, and you can see that it worked perfectly. You can see the green markers, but you can see it's very, very, very hard to see. This texture is a pretty low poly texture, and you can see the scan is has been simplified quite a lot for the purpose of this CGI post. Typically, it doesn't look this pixelated, but this is like reduced down to like a million polygons. You can kind of see I have the shop with the shop lighting. It's not one-to-one, it's just meant to look close enough. But you can see it's pretty cool. And then it's purple here because we didn't texture, the texture is not imported. But yeah, I hope this video was at least somewhat interesting to you guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.